Gold Live online broadcast. Online broadcast. Featuring your favorite sports and entertainment. Music, food, financial literacy, business, shopping, human interest stories, movies, good vibes, e-games, and many more. If it's live, it's alive. Gold Live, your life. Gold Live online broadcast. Online broadcast. Featuring your favorite sports and entertainment. Music, food, financial literacy, business, shopping, human interest stories, movies, good vibes, e-games, and many more. If it's live, it's alive. Gold Live, your life. Gold Live sports and entertainment. Gold Live Sports.
All right. Hello, ballers. Welcome once again to the Big Fundamental Basketball Academy. My name is Coach Joseph Romarate. We are here now live at the Gold Live Zamboanga Studio. Yeah, naka-broadcast kita ara, live na live, na dito na Facebook page. And of course, akin na Gold Live Zamboanga. And as well, we are broadcasted via the eMedia Mo platform. We can view this stream na eMedia Digital TV Channel 40. Of course, talitaming kita na Sky Cable Channel 54, Mindanao Cable Television Channel 98, and of course, we are also streaming via the eMedia Mo Facebook pages na eMedia Mo, E105.9 eMedia Mo FM, and of course na eMedia Mo Sports TV. All right? So, este noche, dito na bisita, sitas panta ustedes, porque hindi sambuanggeño el bisita dito. Our guest tonight is none other than Coach Potit de Vera. So, we are aware kita na chenetamin kita viewers no from Manila and of course, other parts of the Philippines. Kay sabi ustedes, este dito bisita, un sikat coach. Pero el bonito aquí, bien ledjao. Ele con el mga Sambuanggeño players, no? And of course, Sambuanga basketball itself. Later on, we will hear from Coach Potit, no? El disu you take or disu you thoughts about Sambuanga basketball. Anyways, for the viewers na taga Manila, no? Or other parts of the Philippines, if you are wondering why nagchachabakano po ako dito. By the way, just to inform you, we are broadcasting live locally here at Zamboanga City, mostly yung viewers natin are from Zamboanga. But since syempre, special yung bisita natin, I will take this opportunity of course naman para ma-practice yung Tagalog ko. Ayan. I hope you will bear with me, but anyways, no worries po tayo, ha, mga kabola, mga kabolers, our guest tonight, no, very well known, no, as a coach and of course commentator, sikat na sikat 'yan. Nakita ko nga, namimiss siya na yung 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah. Anyways, for the next hour or so, we will provide you with napakaraming bagay na matutunan natin. Manada kita ko sa aprende este noche, mga vivientes, coming from one of the finest and best coach dito aki na Philippine basketball. No? Anyways, of course, greet muna natin yung mga regulars di atun, no? Talia sila. Si Grebani Rublico. Ah, good evening contigo, Greb. Shoutout sa'yo. And of course, Kiregatso rin di gracias. We really like to express our gratitude sa mga viewers natin na mga OFW. Ah, pagdating na nga ng ano, basta di noche ya. Check attendance na, mga OFWs natin. Sabi nila, abla sila. Part na to coach ng ano, ng nightly routine natin, no? Yung mga kaibigan natin dyan, the original Allen Iverson of Zamboanga, si Bryant Ambali. Ah, yung mga El Barcada de Atun, de Alina Australia, Peng Peng Concepcion, Francis Antonio, Alex Nerona, shoutout contigo, brother. No? Yes, as I'm saying, no, shoutout sa inyo, mga present heroes natin, mga OFWs. No? And because of that, you deserve this applause. Ayan. Palakpakan natin yan yung mga ano, viewers dito nali, no? And of course, we invite you to please like and share, of course, yung page The Gold Live Zamboanga. And of course, please share the stream para makarating ito, no? Or Liga Este, mas manada gente pwede mira. Ha? Diba? And of course, abangan nyo, no? Spera-spera kita, Ben Manada Bonito programa, aki na Gold Live. Tomorrow, we will have the Guess and Win. Ha? And of course, episode El Biyahe with Kuya Noor. Watch out naman ustedes, no? Si Lando Bisaya will also be featured here. So many more programs pa. Por eso, don't hesitate to like the page and share it to your friends, coworkers, o maskin ken pase. Ah, diba? This is the new kind of media or entertainment that you will experience. First time here in Zamboanga, world-class entertainment para con ustedes magasambanggenyo. And of course, we'd like to express our gratitude to our sponsors. Of course, first is yung Goldstone. Ah, if you need supplies like alcohol, PPEs, face mask, and LDila bestseller, no? Ela air purifier or this personal air purifier. Ben pasi lang kasi usa. Just easy, just one click. And then, automatic, it will purify the air around you. Ah, this is very much important, mga viewers, no? Especially this time of pandemic, we need that extra protection for ourselves and most especially to our loved ones. And of course, they also have smoke disinfectant machines, no? If you want to disinfect your cars, of course, your homes, offices, aki lang say na Goldstone. If you need or if you want to order, you may contact them at their numbers 0936-492-1965 and 0926-965-3204. And of course, si medyo tantamad kita po ko laba, ha? Or kaya kada manada e labada, kaya kada kat osedes busy pirmi, mira maga programa akin na Gold Live. Ha? Chene kita tamen ali El Queen's Laundry. Ha? Si kera osedes imbunamente, pulido, oloroso, ilimpio e labada. Chene sila branches ali na Giwan, Lunzuran, Tumaga, Tugbungan, and Santa Maria. Ha? Tali lang sila mga barangays nearby. Or you can also buy here Akel Intra Juice. Ha? Si Akel ustedes mga health conscious, kere keda kondisyon, kumpre ustedes eh, Intra Juice. And of course, El Albarey Advertising Corporation. I would also like to rindi tamen gracias con El Diatun Barkada, si Eric Estolatan. Ben bonito El Diatun Hoodie Ara. Big Fundamental Basketball Academy Hoodie. Rick, Diatun Barkada, aki si Idol. Mga barkada daton kasi Chris pati si Cherry. Bonito daw tamin to usa tamin sila ang sina hoodie. Anyways, rindi tamin kita gracia. Of course, konel maga Tamira Ara. Prince Enriquez Torres is watching. Mga OFWs, Talia, Benhar Usab. Shoutout sa'yo, brother. Albert Alban, shoutout na Kulyanan. Thank you for watching. Choi Ignacio. Mga viewers, abangan nyo. Malapit na yung interview with Choi Ignacio. Ben manada aga Choi, tan request. Okay? Now, without further ado, no, tignan natin kung available na ba si Coach Potit. And then, introduce na natin siya. Okay? So, we'll see kung available na ba si Coach. Tawagan natin siya. Okay, Coach?
Hello, Coach Joseph. Loud and clear ba ako?
Yes, loud and clear, Coach.
Okay.
Yun, nice, yan. Nice. Nakita nila, Coach, yung... For the first time para sa iba, makikita na nila kung sino ba si Coach Potit. Ayan, alam nyo Coach, medyo yung mga followers natin dito, they are wondering, sino ba tong si Coach Potit? Sabi nila sa akin, Coach Joseph, at bakit siya yung guest natin ngayon? Sabi ko, ay nako, napakaswerte nyo. Sa sobrang busy ni Coach Potit, pinaunlakan nila niya tayo ngayon. Ha? So for that, thank you very much Coach. Ha? At the bottom of our heart, sabi ko nga sa kanila,
My pleasure.
Yes, Coach. Sabi ko nga sa kanila, in Chabacano pa, manadagat ustedes ko sa aprende. And you will be surprised, no? How knowledgeable si Coach sa Zamboanga Basketball. Because if I'm not mistaken, he has been here for a couple of times, Coach, right? Ilang beses na kayo nakapunta dito.
Okay? True.
Well, yung bida sa show natin ngayon is of course si Coach Potit. Coach, I will give you the time ngayon to greet our viewers and of course, introduce yourself a little bit.
For fall, good evening to everyone, to your viewers, no? Coach Joseph, napakaganda nung show na to, and very privileged to be here. I'm just ready, no? Medyo ninenervyos ako, di ako marunong magtsabaka ano eh, but yung 10-year-old son ko right now, I'm asking him to study a foreign language at ang napili niya Spanish.
So, wow.
Kahit pa paano, may pagkatsabakaano na yun.
Yeah. Very near. Coach, by the way, coach ha, nanonood ngayon si Andy Baroka. Oh, Mark Andy. Anyways, guest natin yan ngayong Sabado. Sorry, Andy Baroka pala. Sorry. Anyways, coach, just as I said, no, medyo intrigue yung mga, alam mo na, yung mga viewers dito. Sino ba si Coach Potit? Well, kami as a coach, we know you very well. Later on, i-discuss natin. Ako, napaka-excited ako yung tinatawag nilang TIP Way. Pero teaser lang sa mga viewers natin kasi it's a successful, should I say, program ba or ano ba? Anyways, you will explain that later, no? Pero Coach, could you please explain to us or your thoughts about Zamboanga Basketball or kung ano ba yung connection nyo na meron dito sa Zamboanga Basketball?
Actually, kasi nung when I was still coaching the FEU UAAP Juniors team back in 2003 all the way to 2008, we had an influx of Zamboanga players, no? Players from Zamboanga. I think it started with Jens Newtel.
Okay.
Jens Newtel, then sumunod na si RJ Argamino, Boy Eding, and then I've worked with sila Mark Baroka sa FEU College at that time. Mark Baroka, RR Garcia, Chris Elorpe, no? Puro mga, ika nga ako, if we talk about Zamboanga Basketball, ang unang pumapasok sa utak ko is point guards. Point guard factory. It's a point guard factory. So if we recruit players or may nagtatryout sa amin and then I realize na point guard siya and then tinanong ko, taga saan? And if they say Zamboanga siya, medyo may preference kagad ako doon. Ano? So, and that's during the 2007, my first time to visit Zamboanga because we had the Athletes in Action Philippines had a tour team. No, na pumunta dyan. And I think you were there, Coach Joseph, then, no?
Yeah.
Yung kaibigan natin doon si from G-Boy, si Sir Omar Basiri.
Of course.
Was our host together with the late Pastor Ke ng Kamakop Churches dyan sa Zamboanga, no. We were hosted there sa Zamboanga to run some camps and then sa gabi sa through G-Boys sa G-Boys, no, may mga tune-up games tayo doon, ano, and those were great games. And ang pinaka-memorable sa akin really was lahat ng games were jam-packed and very secured. We had yung kapulisan natin, our police force was there also watching, and there was actually one game na ang kalaban natin dyan were military / police officers na team, ano, kalaban ng AIA team, and that was just very memorable for us. Also, yung mga friends natin na nakilala because of that experience, na notably si Coach Roy yes. Lim ng Claret. Claret pa ba ngayon? Di ko na alam.
Yes,
ano,
yes. Doon pa rin sa Coach. Actually, nanonood siya.
And then si Coach Ronald Rico. Okay. No, or Coach Rico for short. No, those two coaches were very close to my heart, no, especially nung time na nakilala ko sila noong 2007 together with Omar Basiri.
Okay. Sabi nga dito ni Coach Roy Lim, sabi niya, one of the best coach, idol, Coach Potit. Napakarami niyong fans dito. And kanina, Coach, ano, nakikita ko, ang daming nag-share ng ano natin, banner natin. One of that is Jens Newtel and yung mga ibang players niyo. Si Edding, sabi niya, Coach Potit, one of the best skills trainer or skills coach. Wow, grabe. Coach, ako, I'm excited, Coach. Hopefully, makabalik kayo, Coach, na makagawa tayo ng collab project dito sa Zamboanga, no? Having heard that straight from the players, ah, di ba?
Yeah, actually, a few months before nagkaroon ng lockdown, I was there in Sibugay,
mm-hmm,
together with some of our other Athletes in Action coaches. We had our coaches camp there and then may mga pinakilalang players to work them out. But yeah, nandun kami sa Sibugay, then we passed by Zamboanga before heading home to Manila.
Ayan, so Kami dito, coach, alam nyo, it doesn't happen really often na may mga bisita na, alam mo na, yung mga sabi nga nilang dekalibra na, coach. So, hoping talaga, coach, in the future, well, hindi malayong mangyari yan. Knowing nga na yung Zamboanga is grabe. Zamboanga nga is, tawag nila, ay basketball-crazed city. So, I'm sure nasa MPBL na kayo. For the record, no, I'm not sure, no, pero accordingly, nung nag-host ng home game yung Zamboanga, ito yung pinakamaraming attendance na nanood. Okay? So, just to show na grabe pagdating nga sa basketball yung Zamboanga. But anyway, some for the viewers, no, especially sa mga taga-Zamboanga, yun, na-establish na natin na si Coach Putit, no, na legit yan, napakalaking contribution sa Zamboanga basketball. Why? Yung mga stars natin ngayon na naglalaro at nag-excel sa Manila, part of their success ay dahil kay Coach Putit. Ah, di ba? Kung ano sila ngayon, sabi nga ng isang player eh, one of the best skills coach. Pag yan ang sinabi ng isang player, totoo yan. They will never forget that me as a player and as a coach, pag sinabi na ng player yan in public, ibig sabihin, totoo yan. Ha? Kumbaga, yun ang napakalaking endorsement. Okay, Coach, we will just pause for a... Anyway, sorry, akala ko for a break na sabi ng tropa natin dito. Anyways, Coach, no? Personally, Coach, syempre, nag-understand nyo yung mga Zamboangueño players. Like, yung mga naman na-mention nyo, sina Jens, no, sina Edding, RJ Argamino. Ano yung nakita nyo, coach, sa mga Zamboangueño player na medyo unique, no? Medyo unique sa ibang players.
Well, right out of the bat, they're really skilled in terms of playing the point guard position, you know, ball handling nila. I think yun nga, ako, I'm very publicly, I always tell them about Zamboanga being a point guard factory. Oh, I just remembered, ano, you had Gino Jumawas as your guest the other day, no? And ay, magandang story ako rin dyan, ano, because nga, ay, nakwento niya naman na I mistook him for a college player, high school pa pala, but because I was so impressed by him, by his skills, skill level, ano, nasasayangan ako kung hindi siya, if he cannot go against better competition, not putting Zamboanga basketball down, but if Gino Jumawas sa Zamboanga is already a tall player, diba? So, yung limit niya, I mean, yung potential niya malilimit. So, he has to go up against taller players, bigger players, older players, no? Eh, dyan nga sa Zamboanga, nung time na yon, college players, nagtatryout siya. Kinain niya ng buhay lahat ng college players nun, and he was still in high school. So, nasayangan ako, and I really did something, ano, talagang ginawa namin ng paraan to bring him to Manila to be exposed here, ano? And it turned out well for him, and he's playing again for at a high level, ano? Yes. And all things work for him at the time, di ba, nasa Zamboanga MPBL team din siya, so kahit papaano magandang endorsement yan for Zamboanga basketball altogether.
Yes, well, coach, no, as you've said, no, yung Zamboanga ngayon is a, sabi nyo nga, is a point guard factory. Well, of course, gusto rin namin na, ano, of course, magkaroon rin ng mga forwards, syempre shooting guards, small forward. What can you advise, coach, especially as mga coaches and mga coaches na nanonood dyan na kahit pa paano makaproduce din kami? Kasi that's true, coach, no? Halos lahat dito gusto maging point guard eh. Could you like give us an advice kung ano ba dapat namin gawin dito as general para makaproduce naman kami ng other, ano, other positions?
Well, number one, magpalaki sila, no? Matangkad. And yun lang lang, in general, yun lang nakita ko sa Zamboanga. Hindi matatangkad karamihan ng players. And then kung may matangkad, I remember pag may makausap ako from the provinces, coach, may player ako rito, sentro. Ah, talaga? Oh, ang malaki. Anong height? 6'2". Oh, sabi ko, 6'2", eh. Gwardiya lang dito yan. Ano magiging sentro yan, di ba? So, I think it's not a bad thing na lahat ng players sa Zamboanga gusto magkwardiya. For me, Coach Joseph, no? Because yes. Actually, the way basketball is being played right now, parang the big center is being obsolete. Ano? Nagiging obsolete na. Being replaced by stretch bigs. Tanga, di ba? Mga big man na may tira sa labas. But I'd even like to go bring it further, no? Hindi lang big man na may tira sa labas, but rather big men who can really play like a guard. Yun ang pangarap ko. No? I find it amusing when people talk about stretch bigs. Ah, pang-international na to dahil yung big man may shooting sa labas. Ah. Kulang eh, bitin pa rin yun eh. I think a big man should be able to possess guard skills. I think that's the ultimate player. Matangkad na kaya maglaro ng kahit anong position. And right now sa Zamboanga, playing the guard position is not bad because anytime na bigla kang tumangkad, but ang orientation mo is being the guard, the advantage sa'yo when you have that growth spurt. But playing the forward and center position for Zamboanga, for you to develop those fly kind of players, una-una kailang tumangkad muna talaga sila. You know? And 6'3 right now cannot cut it for a center. No? 6'4 cannot cut it for a center right now.
Yun. So napakaganda ng sinabi nyo, coach. No? Actually nga, dito na yung mga some of your players din. No? Sabi nila, may kilala akong point guard na malakas, taga Zamboanga. Jens Newtel yung pangalan daw. Anyways, andyan, watching yung kaibigan natin, si Jens, always supporting it. Ah, may nagsasabi rin, best coach for best haircut, si Aaron Eborde. Ino, coach, ha, dito kasi show natin, medyo pinapansin natin yung mga viewers natin. Alam nyo na.
Isa-shoutout ko yun, si Aaron. Yan yung barbero ko kanina. Napakagaling, tsaka ang daming kwento. Aaron, ayan, ha? Di ako nag-ano, ha? Di ako bumaliktad sa pag-usapan natin.
Yun. Tama. Andyan din si Dexter D. Ah, Coach Potit de Vera, kamusta ka na? Ito, ewan ko, Coach, kung dumaan ba to sa inyo, Coach. Si Mehmet Ascanio. Sabi niya, hello, Coach. Musta? Isang point guard din from Zamboanga. Nung high school siguro, naglaro siya sa Chiang Kai-shek.
I worked with him sa Chiang Kai-shek and then he transferred to CEU nung college. I really wanted him sa TIP pero he preferred to just stay sa CEU or go back home to Zamboanga.
Ah, okay. Now, coach, no, na-establish na natin yung connection nyo sa mga Zamboanga players. Well, right now, yung gusto namin malaman naman is how you started basketball. Ano ba yung basketball story nyo? Could you recall yung pinaka-earlier years nyo as a player or as a coach ba? Could you enlighten us, coach, please?
Yeah, but yun nga, nung elementary ako, I never played basketball. I was a late bloomer. I actually learned how to play intelligent basketball or I learned to play basketball na may forma na talaga. Second year high school pa lang. So very late in the game na ako nag-start. But I think it's because of the sports that I played back when I was in elementary. Na mabilis yung aptitude ko for sports, no? So when I decided to play basketball, I learned quickly and then I played no fourth year high school ako back in 92. I played for the Ateneo Blue Eaglets, no, a UAP juniors team, and fortunately I got recruited by Coach Aric Del Rosario, the late Coach Aric Del Rosario for UST, but never really got it going then for college, you know, because number one, I was just a small kid. Maybe above average, no, pero still a small kid. Tapos ang ilalaban mo, itatapat mo sa akin sa UST, Paul David, Patrick Fran, Shot Tankinson. So these are big names na matagal na nagba-basketball. Kaya ako, baguhan pa rin ako sa basketball, though I could have done a lot, no, but ang dami ko pang hindi nalalaman talaga about basketball, and it did not help me in my college career. So I cut it short as early as 96, no? And but I was still playing high level pa rin, but and then I just started coaching when I met Binky Favis, and this started everything really for me when I met Binky Favis, who back then when UST days ko, he was the assistant coach of Coach Aric, kaya magkakilala na kami. So back in early 1999, I met him sa Time Zone sa Glorieta, Makati. It was the parang opening month pa lang ng Time Zone. So bago pa lang yung Time Zone sa Pilipinas. And we met and I told him about my aspirations of being a coach. And at that time, hindi ko alam, Binky Favis was just named head coach ng Letran. And it was a bit odd, no? Medyo may pagka-weird na when we were talking doon sa Time Zone, parang he was actually discouraging me or painting a sad life of a coach. parang ganun yung pinipaint niyang picture sa akin at that time. Parang, sigurado ko ba? Kasi mahirap ang buhay ng coach. May girlfriend ka na ba? May asawa ka na ba? Kasi kung meron, baka hindi maintindihan ng partner mo ang buhay ng isang coach. So parang mga discouraging words. No? But I told him, kaya nga I'm here to pursue it, sabi ko. And then when he felt na I was sure, sige, pakita ka sa akin sa next week. No? Ako head coach ng Letrano, ikaw na assistant coach ko. So that was the start of everything, you know, back in 1999. But things did not go well for me, no, between me and Binky nung time na yon, because number one, I think mentally, emotionally, I was not ready to pay the price to be a good assistant coach or a good coach, no, at that time. I still had some bad habits. Meron pa akong mga konting bisyo sa buhay ko noon, which did not really help my situation with Coach Binky, because Coach Binky demanded excellence, which I bring it with me now. But during that time, no, so it was cut short on a sour note, but eventually we patched things up. So okay naman. After that, 99, I became the assistant coach naman of Coach Eric Gonzalez ng Iloilo. Sa MPBL now. At that time, Coach Eric was the head coach of the PCU Juniors team sa NCAA Juniors. No? Ang star player namin doon at that time was Ron J. Buenafe.
Okay.
So, back in 2000. So, ganun na ako kabata pa. No? And then, by 2001, the first ever head coaching job ni Lawrence Chongson was for the Pangasinan team ng MBA. And that was the last year of the MBA. No? And I was the assistant coach ni Lawrence Chongson for his first ever head coaching job. And then 2002, nag-fold na kasi yung MBA ng 2001. So 2002, I met up with Eric, Coach Eric and Coach Nash Rosella. Back then, they were the head coaches of Batangas Blades sa MBA. And they were transitioning from the MBA to the PBL. And they talked to me about if I was interested working with them sa Batangas Blades, sa PBL. And I was thinking na volunteer status na naman to. So okay lang, walang problema. Because I really wanted to coach. I really wanted to be there sa coaching because I really wanted it. Then later on, when I decided na sasama ako sa coaching staff ni Nash, on our first meeting, they revealed to me na may sweldo pala. They were just... Niloloko lang nila ako, playing a prank, ano, and they're still like that until now, no, very light-hearted, ano. So, yun, my first ever na sweldong malaki, courtesy of the Batangas Blades management. And then, yung Batangas Blades mismo, nag-fold. So, hindi na sumali sa PBL after a year. So, and during those times, we were friends with Goldwyn Monteverde. No? I befriended Goldwyn Monteverde. And in 2003, kinuha niya ako assistant coach sa St. Stephen's High School. And that blossomed into a great relationship and a working relationship with Goldwyn. All the way hanggang naging head coach siya ng Adamson Juniors, kailan lang, ano? Bago siya lumipat sa NU, I was there helping him out sa mga programa niya, sa teams niya. But back then in 2003 also, Coach Mike Oliver and Coach Eric Gonzalez, nagpalitan lang sila, they were tapped as head coaches ng FEU Fern High School. It is not the UAAP Juniors team yet. Ha? It was just an FEU High School team na hindi kasama sa UAAP at that time. And at that time, they were busy with a lot of things and they asked me to be their volunteer coach, assistant coach. Primarily, an unofficial head coach doing the job for them because they couldn't make it all the time sa FEU campus sa May Quezon City because they were busy sa Manila. So, I did that. And from 2003 to 2005, I was the volunteer coach of the FEU high school team. No? And then during that time then, 2003, pinalitan ko si Coach Eric Gonzalez sa coaching staff ni Koy Banal sa FEU Seniors. And that started it off with me and Coach Koy Banal sa FEU Seniors from 2003 all the way to 2008. And then by 2005, the FEU management decided na mag-UAAP Juniors na sila. No? And together with Coach Glenn Capacio, I was the head coach of the FEU UAP Juniors team until 2008. And that's where I met Jens Newtel, RJ Argamino, and Si Moya Eding. By 2008, I was reflecting on quitting already, no, coaching both sa seniors and juniors, no, 2008. Just because I was more concerned about my family time, yung quality life ko with my family, which was really taking a toll during that time. And I was really, it was a struggle, no, Joseph. It was a struggle because I didn't want to leave coaching, but I think I had to at that time. But God had different plans for me, no? So sparing me from a dilemma to choose between staying and quitting, God spared me by one day, December of 2007, I just signed a 1-year extension with FEU. Yeah, December 2007. And that was the time I was already contemplating of quitting, no? After signing, but nandun na. By January 2008, FEU let me go. No, they went to another direction, and sinabi nila, we had to let you go, put it. Salamat na lang. No? But FEU did the most honorable thing, and they still honored that contract. Ano? So from January 2008 all the way to December 2008, I was still getting paid, no, yung salary ko sa FEU. But 2008, after ko matanggal sa FEU, kinuha ako ni Aboy Castro sa UP, UAP Seniors, and that started off. So there was a year, there was a UAP season na nasa UP ako, may sweldo ako sa UP, and it was good enough. And but FEU was also paying me that time.
Wow.
So dalawa sweldo ko, no? So
wow.
Yeah, blessing talaga. And Joseph, ang magandang blessing lalo doon was because, again, I was in a position to quit sa FEU because of family time, yung quality time ko with my family. UP being 10 to 15 minutes away from my house, solved everything. So, yeah, God is good, no? Pagdating doon sa sitwasyon na yun. So, from 2008 to 2010, I was with the UP Maroons kay Coach Aboy Castro. And after there, I had a change of heart again, and instead of coaching basketball in a traditional way, mm-hmm, I committed myself, starting 2010, I committed myself doing sports ministry work. And that's where Athletes in Action came in, really. No? I was with Athletes in Action since 2000. But 2010, that's where I really decided that I will go full-time, parang full-time ministry with Athletes in Action. And during that time, I was feeling the burden of providing more for my family. So prayed to the Lord one Wednesday, no, ano pa ba ang, what is still in store for me? My heart, my desire to coach is still there. So ano ba talaga, Lord, no? And then after that Wednesday of prayer, Thursday, tumawag si Lawrence Chongson as I was driving sa may Ortigas area to for my wife who works there at that time. Tumawag si Lawrence Chongson, and ang bungad niya, oh ano, Ted Fu. Yun ang nickname niya sa akin, Ted Fu. Oh, Ted Fu, ano, pwede ka bang assistant coach ko? O saan? Sa Boracay Rum, sa PBA D-League.
D-League.
Ha? O kailan mo kailangan yung sagot ko? Bukas. Grabe naman. O sige, pag-isipan ko. So Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday, I was an assistant coach again. In a traditional way, I was a coach,
wow,
again. It was again a blessing because Lawrence Chongson as a head coach was not that heavy on work time. So I had a lot of time to do my ministry work pa rin with Athletes in Action. So that really was okay. And then by sa dulo ng 2011, I felt the desire to be a head coach. Parang, oh, ministry work ako with Athletes in Action. So it's still a coach, assistant coach ako sa PBA D-League, but for the longest time, I was yearning to be a head coach again. Ano? Yung running my own program, putting in this and that. Ano? By 2011, December, tumawag yung coach ng PIP, okay, si Coach Bong Arroyo. Tumawag sa akin ng December. And maybe it was like an October or November where I was pouring my heart out to the Lord about the desire to coach a team. And si Bong Arroyo called me noong December of 2011 informing me that he was about to quit TIP and he was providing a shortlist for the owners. And in-inform niya ako na nandun yung pangalan ko. And but at it was a long list, a short list, but it was long. it was a big list. Pido Jarencio, wow. Sandy Arespacuchaga, Gabby Severino, JB Season, who is now in San Beda. So maraming mga who's who. And then parang feeling ko ako lang yung naiiba. No? So that December, I got interviewed by the boss of TIP, si Sir Jello. And then sabi niya, oh, sige coach, tatawagan ka na lang namin kung nakapag-decide na kami. Okay. January passed, walang tawag. February was about to pass, wala pa rin tawag. I think, Joseph, kahit isang buwan, 1 month lang na hindi ka tinawagan, yes, alam mo nang hindi ikaw eh. Diba? And this was already 2 months. And I was resided in the fact na, I resided in the fact na, hindi na ako yan, imposible na ako. But, come dulo ng February, or early, very early in March, Sir Jello, the TIP boss, called me up and said na ako na yung coach nila. And wow, he wanted me to come to TIP to talk specifics and to just tour me around the campus sa Manila and meet the team. Wow. And that was it. March 2012, I was the coach of TIP. They just came from a championship season, ano, yung team na yon na may inherit ko. The first thing I did was to retain 7 of the 15 players na nag-champion sa liga nila. It was mind-boggling for everyone, even for Sir Jello. No? But I had a vision already of what I wanted to do. And I had a vision and a clear picture of who I wanted or the type of players that I wanted to have. Does it matter if I win or lose? I just wanted to make sure that the team I had was the team I wanted. No? And ayun, and then 2018, the MPBL came knocking and ayun, nandun ako. So, but unfortunately, itong COVID virus, itong pandemic natin, TIP, sadly, had to dissolve yung kanilang basketball program. So, yeah, I'm unemployed right now, kaya enjoying and very excited actually, Joseph. I'm very excited of what's ahead, no? And very excited and embracing reinvention right now for me.
Well, Coach, basing from your history, hindi na kami magugulat, baka anytime, bigla na lang mag-ring yung cellphone nyo and would offer you a coaching job. Well, you know, Coach, grabe yung ano nyo, grabe yung tawag natin, resume nyo as a coach. Ako, nung narinig ko yan, wow, grabe. Well, Coach, because of that, you deserve an applause. Palakpakan naman tayo ng konti. Diba? Sabi, grabe, Coach, no? Well, ikakat lang kita ng sandali, Coach. We'll just go for a quick commercial break and then may mga follow-up questions ako sa mga sinabi nyo kasi wow, grabe talaga yung resume nyo. So, just a quick lang, makainom lang ng tubig sandali, si Coach, yung dalawang coach, and then we'll be back right away.
Do you need to deliver some small goods? Maybe some papers to your client's office? Goldstone Express Delivery. We deliver. Request on our Facebook page or call us. Get ready your parcel and wait for our courier. It will take about an hour. It is really fast express delivery service. Office to office. Pickup service, express delivery service. All goods are insured. Cash on delivery. www.facebook.com/goldstonecc or call 0926965-3204 or 0949-1600216.
Gold Live Sports and Entertainment.
Okay, and we're back, no? Oh, so yung mga kaka-tune in lang, no, kaka-share lang sa atin ni Coach yung grabing history niya sa linya ng coaching sa basketball, no? How he started it and hanggang ngayon na unemployed siya as of the moment. Na hindi tatagal yan, Coach, no? Anyways, Coach, may question lang ako kasi napakaganda yung sinabi niyo eh. Kasi nung start ng coaching nyo, sabi nyo, medyo discouraged pa kayo na ganito yung coach, my girlfriend ka na ba? You know, things like that. Coach, sa mga aspiring coaches ngayon na who are watching, no, pwede nyo i-explain ng konti kung gaano ba ka-busy or demanding yung life of a coach, especially sa high level na gaya ng teams nyo?
Well, I think unang-una, the most logical answer to that is it would depend on the head coach, ano, na you will be serving under or working with, how demanding yung head coach mo ngayon, sa magbabase, no, yung basis ng workload mo as an assistant coach. But I think the real answer there, Joseph, is for those who really want to coach or want to make something out of coaching, it doesn't matter what is asked of you. What matters the most is really what you ask from yourself. I always use this and always naka-imprint to sa puso ko, no, yung tinuro ng dad ko, no, ng dad ko sa akin, the late Tony De Vera, na kung may gagawin ka na lang din naman, gawin mo na ng tama. So hindi pwedeng basta-basta lang, ano? And that is where I'm coming from when I go around running our Athletes in Action coaching camps, ano? Ay, yung heart ko to really enlighten and equip yung mga grassroots coaches natin. Because they're the first liners. Eh. Yan ang mga frontliners natin sa basketball.
Tama,
eh.
Tama.
Bago dumating sa college coaches yan, dumaan na yan sa grassroots coaches. And that all spells all the success ng basketball program natin dito sa bansa natin. It starts all with the grassroots coaches. So, for all the aspiring coaches, you have to want, and you really have to be excited working, you know, working hard, long hours, studying your craft, being masters of your craft. Kahit anong level ka pa, in anything you do, hindi lang coaching, ano, the willingness to be the master of your craft. I think that's the key to anyone, to any endeavor.
Yo, napakaganda, Coach, no? Well, ito nga sabi ko rin sa mga ibang coaches eh, kasi you started as volunteer, di ba, as coaches. Siguro nakailang teams kayo na medyo tawag nila na...
Joseph, I'll just cut you. Siguro,
yes, go ahead.
Another advice for aspiring coaches, wag niyong hintayin na bayaran kayo to do great work. You just do the work well, do your best despite kung meron or walang sweldo. Because that is what is asked of you. Now, usual do darating yan if you've proven yourself. I think that's the one thing na most of our young coaches right now, hindi nila mag-grasp yun eh, yung prinsipyong yun. A lot of coaches right now, young coaches, for every work that they do, gusto nila may kapalit kagad eh. I will not pay for someone who I don't know how to work or I don't know yung quality of his work. And I will not pay for anybody's learning curve. Ika nga, ayokong babayaran ka, tapos saka ka palang matututo. Hindi pwede rin yun, di ba? And that is where volunteerism really comes in. Ano? The willingness to be a volunteer coach for how long it takes and for how long God blesses you with sweldo, di saka ka makakasweldo. But before that, be willing to just work your best, no? Kahit walang sweldo.
Yun yung gusto kong i-point out din, Coach, no, especially sa mga aspiring coaches, na kung gusto mong mag-coach and then yung first talaga nasa isip mo is to earn or umaman, well, you're in the wrong craft, my friend, or you're in the wrong profession. Kung gusto mo kakapasok ko pa lang, gusto ko na malaki ng sweldo, may sweldo agad, di ba? Mostly na nakita natin na great coaches like you, dumaan talaga yung sabi nila pro bono muna. Ah, matuto ka muna and I'm sure, Coach, napakaraming coach na who mentored you. No, siguro kung hindi ka nag-volunteer, kung gusto mo agad na babayaran ako, I'm sure you will not be the kind of coach that you are right now. Ah, 'di ba? I'm sure gumastos ka rin siguro sa mga coaches clinic, di ba? Mga things like that. Ito yung mga investment as a coach na later on would really benefit you, di ba? Now, Coach, medyo, alam nyo na, may nagtanong sa akin dito, nag-PM, ano ba daw yung, ano, yung athletes in action? Kasi nakita ko, Coach, a big part kung bakit successful kayo ngayon is because of this program. Because God is in your side. Di ba? Sabi nyo nga, may mga times na medyo in a dilemma na sana kayo. And then suddenly, through, maybe siguro, ako, personal take ko lang, siguro, God's intervention nung pagkuha sa inyo sa, ano, sa TIP. Knowing na yung nandyan sa shortlist na napakamahabang list, napakamagagaling na mga coach, pero kayo pa rin yung napili. Could you enlighten us further, Coach, kung ano ba tong ano, athletes in action?
Yeah, first and foremost, yes, God is good God is good. Kahit hindi naman ako na-bless, ano, God is still good. Pero we're just in hindsight lang, looking back, na ito yung mga nangyari sa akin magaganda. That's why God is good. But kahit hindi naman magaganda yung nangyayari sa akin, like right now, no, wala akong trabaho, but God is still good. No? Yun lang, iniiwasan ko lang na isipin na parang anting-anting or lucky charm si God, you know, because you know, He is more than that.
Yes.
But going back, Athletes in Action really is a sports ministry organization in the States. It's been in the States for 60-70 years na. No? And what really Athletes in Action is the upliftment of the human spirit through sports, you know, and sharing God's word through sports. And I got into that because nung bata ako, high school pa lang, in our own community, an Athletes in Action tour team from the States, composed of Division I NCAA players, they would usually visit the Philippines and go around the country playing games, and then just to have that chance also to be a witness and the ability to share God's love sa buhay ng mga taong kalaro nila. And from 1990 all the way to 1993, I was subjected to the AIA US tour team. I played against them for 3 straight years, no? And I met the head, the director of Athletes in Action in the Philippines. Na-meet ko na siya since 1990. No? That's where the story started. Umikot na 2003, and I met again si Brother Toti Andes, who I met noong 1990, and he was the head of Athletes in Action. 2003, because of Eric Gonzalez, nagkaroon kami ng mga Bible studies for coaches, and I was reintroduced to Athletes in Action again. And that started it. Ano? Again, na-relieve lang ang lahat. No? And Athletes in Action dito sa Pilipinas is also committed to the same charge, you know, meaning uplifting the human spirit, enlightening them, you know, sharing God's principles to them in connection to sports. So, yeah, anytime you embrace God, I mean, positive things will happen, you know. I mean, it's not going to be a perfect life. It's not going to be all bells and whistles. All prizes, all championships. No, it's actually the other way around, no. But I think it's going to be there's going to be a positive effect sa perspective mo, how you see things now, no? And I think yun lang naman, ano? So it's not really because of success that's why God is good, but it really just changes your perspective to the best perspective, no, when you embrace God. So yun lang naman ang Athletes in Action, and we still continue to do it until now. Yun nga, sabi ko nung start ng program is a few months back, nasa Cebu Gay lang kami, teaching grassroots coaches how to coach with deeper meaning, with a deeper purpose.
Yun. So I'm very much impressed, Coach, no? Kung napaka-unique nyo na coaches, na sa dami ng na-coaches ko rin na na-meet, no? Especially na nakikita ko mostly yung center talaga ng your craft or the way you do things is God, which is yun naman talaga dapat, because He's in control of everything. Now, Coach, yung next na gusto naming malaman, no? Knowing your experiences, yung mga na under kayo ng mga coaches. Now, gusto namin malaman, you personally as coach, ano ba yung tawag natin na philosophy nyo as coach or paano ba kayo mag-practice o ano ba yung sistema nyo? Would like to hear it from you naman, coach.
I think it starts with this phrase lang, ano, na basketball is a game of skills and a battle of wills. Mm. I think my whole philosophy revolves around that phrase. Basketball is a game of skills, no? It's not a game of centers. It's not a game of forwards. It's not a game of guards. It's a game of skills. So, with that statement alone, or that urges me, or dun pumapasok yung kagustuhan ko na lahat ng player should be skilled from the guard's skill to the big man's skill. So, sa mga teams na na-handle ko, mga players that I've worked with, they're pretty much balanced, no? A guard who can post up and but can still play outside, but I also have my bigs who can play from the inside all the way to the outside. Hindi lang siya sentro na may tira sa labas. I'm really trying to develop centers who can play like a guard. So yun yung talagang heart ko. It revolves around that, no? It just revolves around that, and a battle of wills that already guides me on how I should be coaching them, sa mental aspect, sa emotional aspect. So it's a game of skills and a battle of wills. If coaches can really work with that with those two statements, talagang kaya nilang ipasok sa yung players nila sa statements na yun, I think it's going to be a fun basketball. And number two, ako parati ko sinasabi to sa lahat ng coaches who I talk with, especially sa camps and mga players who I work with, na I'm a pretty good shooting coach. No? It's because I believe in shooting. I think that's number one. No? I believe in shooting. That's why it makes me a better shooting coach. It goes because when I started, you know, playing basketball, again, my dad, no? My first ever coach was my dad. Not just in basketball, but in everything. I am the coach that I am right now because of my dad. And when I was still young, I remember my dad telling me about basketball. Unang-una sa basketball, matapat marunong kang shumot. Diba? Parang cliche, no? Siyempre, kailangan mo shumot, diba?
Tama.
But you'd be surprised, Joseph. Maraming coaches naniniwala na kailangan ang player may shooting. Pero not everyone really works at it.
Yun.
Or makes it really important.
Correct.
Diba? Hindi yung, sige, mag-shooting tayo ng 30 minutes. Tapos you expect your players to be shooters agad. No. It really takes a process. It takes a year, 2 years, 3 years, or 4 years. I tell that to all my players that we will work your shooting, but we will work at it every day. Magulat ka, we have practice sessions na 1 hour to 2 hours only devoted to shooting work.
Wow.
That's the kind of coach. That's the kind of practices I run.
Skills talaga.
Sometimes I have 4 hours practice. And this, yeah, exactly. Yan yung iiling yung mga players. But isipin
four mo, hours.
4 hours yung practice, pero 2 hours is just shooting. So okay. Bakit ka angal? Shooting lang yun. And bakit ka angal? Shooting is the best weapon that a player could have. My dad told me, and I believe in this also. No? Again, everything I say is just my belief. So I may be right, I may be wrong, but that's what I believe in. But pag ang player does not know how to shoot, patay barahan na kagad. He's a useless player.
Correct.
Pero may defensive player naman, may ibang rules naman eh. Yeah, but basketball was made with the intention of shooting the ball. Yun, di ba? That's the way basketball will be, should be, will be, and must be played. To shoot the ball. And if you lack that first skill of shooting the ball, then I think you take the fun out of it. Diba? Kahit tayo mga bata, nag-e-enjoy tayo pag nakaka-shoot.
Correct.
Diba? Wala namang...
Pag
but it takes a special kind of player enjoying to play defense. I admit that. No? It takes a special kind of player. Pero yung basic necessity of shooting the ball must be there. No? So, that's number two. So, game of skills, battle of wills. Shooting is number one and top priority sa akin. And then... maybe my last point as to how I view basketball, and that is what drives me and guides me to how I teach basketball. Ano? I would ang dream five ko sa loob ng court would be five Scottie Pippens.
Wow.
So mahirap that explains yan, coach. Mahirap yan sa gawin. Mga teams ko. No, but you'd be surprised. As early as 2005 with the FEU Juniors team, I was able to field in at the same time. Dalawang 6'3", isang 6'4", dalawang 6'5". High school, wow. High school division to. Ah. I was able to put that on the floor at times sa UAP Juniors. A 6'3 playing the guard, another 6'3 playing the wing, another 6'4 playing the wing, and dalawang 6'5 playing the front court position nung high school. So that was Russell Yaya, who played for AYAC sa NCAA. Mm-hmm. It was Raprap Mangahas, at that time one of the best high school players. 6'4 Jolas Pagia. Actually 6'5 da rin siya noon. 6'5 Sok Rivera, who made a name sa UAP by having that Sok Rivera rule. And then Ian Rumbawa was a little of a kakasimula pa lang niya mag-basketball at that time, but he was already 6'5", 6'6", at saka high flyer, no? Dumadang. Sabay-sabay yun, Joseph, na sa court. And I have replicated that in TIP. No? Hindi na ako lalayo, itong last batch, no? before nagkaroon ng na-dissolve yung team ng TIP. No? We already had a 5 na dinidevelop. A 6'4 guard, a 6'5 wow. wing, a 6'5'3 si Brian Santos. I'll name them. RV Yanes, who is now going to play for Adamson, is a 6'4 combo guard. And I was developing him into a point guard. And yung backcourt mate niya, who is now with Derek Pumarin sa Lasal, si Warren Calara, a 6'5 wing. Together with Brian Santos, our MVP na nasa UST na, who is also 6'5. Diba? And then I have 6'6 Ivan Santos, who is in Mapua, who would be playing the power forward dapat sa amin. And then our import, 6'8 Papa Enjay. That was a 5, Joseph, na bubulabog sana sa college basketball itong 2020. Yes. Sayang lang yung nangyari.
Sayang eh.
But it happens. It happens.
Well, coach, no? Having said that, coach, yung 3 points na sinabi nyo, of course, hindi kaya mag-isa nyo yan. Let's face it, that's reality. Ah, di ba? So how do you utilize your assistant coaches? Paano ba ikaw ba yung assigned sa shooting, di ba? Kasi sabi nyo nga pag mag-isa ka for 4 hours, sobrang exhausted na yan. So how do you handle your staff, no, to be able to, you know, makuha nyo itong goal na to?
Well, to be honest, Joseph, no, I think one of my strong points really is my energy. Siguro sa buong 23 years ko of coaching, never pa ako talaga nawalhan ng boses. Number one. Number two, I think my energy. Sa 4 hours of practice, after practice, baka may player pa akong hatakin for 1 hour for extra work.
Grabe.
And I'd be full of energy. Hindi ako yung palautos. I will be moving and really mimicking, demoing the skills na ituturo ko at the game speed intensity pa. You'd be surprised. Nung nag-start ako sa FEU Juniors, I had 45 players sa isang court. Mag-isa lang ako.
Wow!
That was my
sobrang
team
hirap A, nga, coach.
My team B, and my team C. Hindi to bola, no? You could, Mike Tolomia can attest to this because Mike was at that time my team B sa FEU Juniors. And we had those sessions. 3 teams on 1 court, and then mag-isa lang ako, hahatiin ko into smaller groups, and they will be running a lot of different skill drills, no? So naka parang relay, no? Ano ba yan, nawawala ng vocabulary ko. Baka may mga sections,
may mga sections ako.
Oh, iba-ibang drills.
Yes.
For different sections on the court with different groups of players. Tapos umiikot lang ako doon. Umiikot ako, tinuturo ko, nagko-correct ako. I remember Mike Tolomia sa dribble flick pass, no, on the wall. Yun na, alala ko yung mga drills na yun. And And then when it came to my assistant coaches, I just expected them to have that passion to teach players. So sa pag-uusapan namin even before a month or a week or a day or even hours before practices, kung ano ang mga ini-expect kong gagawin nila o ano kaya mong gawin ngayon, what do you feel comfortable doing right now? No? And ano ba ang strengths ng mga, ano ba strengths nyo? Yun muna, sa mga assistant coaches. Diba? I cannot put them in a position they will be unsuccessful. Diba?
Correct.
I want them to flourish. So, ano bang feeling mo kaya mong gawin? Di, sige, doon na ituro mo. O, ito mga players, I want you to work with them before and after practice. Ito yung mga kulang nila. O, work on that. And then I'll hound them. Every practice, pag yung player pumalpak, paminsan pagagalitan ko yung assistant coach. But alam nila yon. My assistant coaches also know this for a fact na I will show our players na sila rin accountable sa akin as coaches if the players don't do what they're supposed to do. So that mas magiging tight yung bond ng assistant coaches with the players also.
Yun. Napakaganda yung sinabi niyo, Coach. Yes, go ahead, Coach. Go ahead.
So para hindi lang pwedeng puro players lang parate ang napagsasabihan.
Correct.
Nang sa ganun, makita ng players na, nako, if I fail my assistant coach, kawawa siya kay head coach.
Mm-hmm.
So, meron din siyang sense of responsibility sa assistant coaches natin. So, that's a good way to start things off also.
Yun, napakaganda, Coach. No? Ako, feeling ko ngayon, napakaswerte ko na rin. Parang ano na to eh, free webinar. Diba? Yung mga ganyang bagay, you will not learn that sa YouTube. You will not learn that sa Google. You could only learn that personally from a great coach with a great mind. Well, of course, Coach, no? Siyempre, napakarami nyo nang alam with regard sa basketball. Pero sabi nga natin na coaching is a lifelong learning experience. So do you still find time pa rin ba ngayon, Coach, na or ano ba yung mga ginagawa nyo to further your knowledge pa na, of course, yung latest basketball trends or plays or drills, may mga ginagawa rin ba kayo ngayon, Coach?
Yeah, I still continue to read books. I'm fond of reading books. Before, meron akong office sa TIP and I have a big bookshelf there and it's filled with books. Lahat yung dinala ko, it's from my personal collection, dinala ko sa office ko sa TIP kasi para hindi na magalit yung misis ko dahil ang kalat na sa bahay. Pero guess
tama,
what?
Tama.
Eh, wala na akong trabaho. I had to bring all my books back home. So, bumalik sa akin. But yeah, I read a lot of books. I watch a lot of videos.
Okay.
I invest. I think one of the assistant coaches ng CSB Blazers, si Paulo Layo, no, special mention. I heard it from him eh, na you have to be willing to invest for your work. No? So hindi pwedeng puro libre. Yun lang eh.
Correct.
No? Yeah, libre is okay sana, no, but when you get something for free, it did not cost you anything, so you are not accountable.
Tama.
Diba? Yung degree of responsibility mo to become better, mababaw eh.
Yes.
Diba?
Si walang
pinakaiba yan pag nandiligaw ka sa babae, eh, diba? Pag madali mo nakuha yung girl eh, parang hindi mo pinaghirapan eh. It's not
worth it
kung pinaghirapan mo eh, diba? Iba
tama,
yun, eh.
Tama.
So yan, ganun din, ano? You really have to be willing to invest sa craft mo. And that entails gagastos ka rin, resources, not just money, but time.
Mm-hmm.
Time. Listening to other coaches, nakuha ko yun, lalo na kay Coach Goldwyn Monteverde, for much of the success that he has been enjoying, you know, he looks forward talking to people and talking and getting insights and advices. Until now. So, these are things that will further enhance your coaching, really.
Yun. So, the reason why tinanong ko yan, Coach, no, kasi napakaraming coaches rin na ako, I'm just talking to the coaches I know, no? Sabi nila, parang ganito eh. Marami na akong alam, naging champion ako na ganito. Siguro tama na to. Pwede na. Pare-pareho lang naman yung mga itinuturo ng iba eh. But that is false, di ba? Sabi ko nga, coaching is a lifelong learning. You should always, sabi nyo nga, listen to other coaches, learn something. Kasi tayo-tayo rin naman magtutulungan, no? Well, Coach Sam, thank you very much for that point, no. Napaka grabe yung mga nasabi nyo ngayon, ha. Worth na i-treasure talaga natin yung knowledge na impart nyo. Well, we'll just go for a quick commercial break, Coach, no. And then we will be back for more, okay, from Coach Potit.
Gold Live Sports and Entertainment. Gold Live.
Goldstone Express Delivery. We deliver. Make a request on our Facebook page or call us. Get ready your parcel and wait for our courier. It will take about an hour. It is really fast express delivery service. Office to office. Fast pickup service. Express delivery service. All goods are insured. Cash on delivery. www.facebook.com/goldstonecc or call 0926965-3204 or 0949-1600216.
Sports and Entertainment. Gold Live Sports and Entertainment.
Okay, we're back here at the Big Fundamental Basketball Academy. Well, Coach, while nasa commercial break tayo, andito na, nanonood na si Sir Omar Basiri. Sabi niya, good evening, Coach Sebastian Potit de Vera. Happy to see you live with the Big Fundamental Basketball Academy. Welcome to the program. By the way, Coach, si Sir Omar is part of this program, itong Big Fundamental Basketball Academy. Kumbaga, siya yung aming ano, alam niyo na, with the knowledge that he has, no, siya yung aming pinaka-head dito, parang executive producer, kumbaga. Ah, so, alam niyo naman, pag sabi natin na father of G-Boys Basketball, ah, sa mga liga dito, none other than Sir Omar Basiri. Ah, yan. Nag-comment rin si Sir Pax Joji. Hello Sir Omar, good to see you here po. Sana makabalik kami ulit sa Zamboanga. Sana nga Coach, kailan kaya Coach? Ha? Siguro soon ha, magpa-plan tayo. Hello Coach, medyo nawala yung ano nyo, audio. Yan na natin sa technical. Sir, ano ba? Baka na loose connection? Or it's okay Coach, try to ano lang so. Baka yung Bluetooth nyo, try nyo i-connect ulit. Anyways, while andyan si Coach, test my Coach. Wala pa rin Coach. Just hold on Coach. We will call you again Coach para ma-reset lang natin. Okay? So, while we're trying to fix pa, no, shoutout lang tayo sa mga nanonood dito sa ano, Big Fundamental Basketball Academy. Once again, we are here live at Gold Live Zamboanga, no? If you want more contents, no, for your tawag nila na online entertainment, okay, please like the page ng Gold Live Zamboanga and of course share this stream because napakaganda yung interview natin with Coach Potit, yung knowledge na sineshare niya sa atin, yung philosophy niya as a basketball coach, di ba? Napakaswerte natin. Kita Daki de Zamboanga, binswerte kayo. Especialmente mga aspiring coaches. And of course, mga tamirali, mga aspiring players. No? At least na pwede amira ustedes. Ko sabay alun coach tabus ka na player. O pakilaya ba si Ginda Kita Alina Manila? Ah, diba? Shout out din kay RR Garcia who is watching right now. Okay? Uy, Mark Cruz. Ah, hi Coach Potit. Thanks for leading us to the championship last 1992. Napakadaming players na nag-under kay Coach Potit na naging very successful sa kanilang mga career, no? So while waiting tayo sa fixing yung connection with Coach Potit, well, may konting ano tayo. Ito muna para sa Zamboanga lang, no? Este para de Zamboanga viewers lang. Ha? Well, price that one, of course. Okay. Big Fundamental shirt. Ha? Ah, si Mira ustedes. Bonito ste. Ano lang, el size de ste is extra large, okay? Okay, I'm good to go, Joseph, Coach Petit. Okay, Coach, we'll sabihin natin sa technical natin dito to call you right back, ah. Oh, mabilis lang yan, Coach. Wait lang saglit. Okay? Trivia question muna tayo. Okay? So, mga de Sambuanga lang, ste. Only for Sambuanga muna. Sorry lang yung mga taga Manila. Okay? Our big fundamental shirt, later on, ira-raffle din natin. Man-raffle tamin kita, este hoodie, big fundamental hoodie. So, el question simple lang. Okay? El aki lang mga yan, share, chene sharers badge, will win this shirt. So, ela ka second lang el man answer. Ela question is kosa ela full name di Coach Putit. Okay? Simple lang, full name el number 2 ken man share amo el winner, ah. Tali si Sir Mark Tamira ken el tan monitor ken el winner. By the way, shout out din kita kuna Sir Omar Basiri. Sir, kamusta yung 3-point shootout diyan sa Golden Boys? Okay, Sir Chris, ready na ba si Sir? Nakukontakt na natin. Okay. So, yung by the way, Coach, if you're listening, may ibang tatawag sa inyo na account. Yung sa technical namin dito, si yung name niya is Elvida sa Facebook. So, just answer his call na lang, Sir. Not my account, but yung account ng ano namin. Ng technical namin dito. So medyo nagluloko yung ano, yung isang browser. So yung name niya is Elvida. Okay? So kung tatawag siya, pakisagot na lang, Coach. Okay, Renny Rodejo, sati sana lutuin ko dito next. pwede, masarap yung sati natin. So once again, we would like to express our gratitude sa mga sponsor natin who continues to support our program. Diba? Kung wala yung sponsor natin, may kita ara kung este bonito programa. No, Taliela. Of course, El Gold Live Sambuanga Studio. Please like the page for more contents and more entertainment. Of course, El Goldstone. Available ali, if you want some alcohol, PPE. Sina mga office ni Sita Ocel, if you will be required to use PPE, chay na kita aki na Goldstone. El pinaka-importante, face mask. Diba? So, aki lang sa'yo na Goldstone. And of course, el air purifier. Este tao sa'yo ara. Ben importante gatste mga bibientes. Si Chene ustedes air purifier. Especialmente este tiempo de pandemic. Okay, I think almost ready na si Coach. Anytime, we will, syempre, makita natin ulit yung mukha ng napakagwapong bagong gupit na coach natin ngayon. Diba? Antayin lang natin si Chris. Inaayos niya lang. Of course, if you want to buy these products, pati na rin yung smoke disinfectant machine, just call them or text them at 0936-492-1965 and 0926-965-3204. And of course, for your laundry needs, kung medyo kansaw ya kita pokot at tamad-tamad laba, taliela Queen's Laundry. Chene sila mga branches na Giwan, Lunzuran, Tumaga, Tumbungan, itambien na Santa Maria. So masinon de ustedes barangay, chene li cerca, Queen's Laundry for your laundry needs. And of course, El Alberay Advertising Corporation. For your advertising needs, just contact Alberay Advertising Corporation. Okay, and now, Coach is back! Yeah, nakapag-water break na ba, Coach? Baka naka-4 hours practice na tayo. Dapat konting water break muna. Welcome back, Coach.
Thank you for your patience. Naubusan ng battery yung Bluetooth earphones ko with the mic. Kaya ito, naka-kable na lang ako, mas dependable.
No problem. Yung mga viewers natin, hindi naman umalis, ha? Napaka-excited sila syempre to hear no yung ano pa yung mga thoughts niyo about basketball. Now, let's go ahead to basketball, Coach, no. Syempre sabi niyo na at yun na mention na yung 3 points niyo as yung philosophy niyo as a basketball coach wherein you really emphasize the skills ng mga players. Well, going tayo now, ha? I'm sure later on maraming gustong maka knowing na the kind of coach you are, marami na diyan yung ay doon kami kay coach kasi mas mas gagaling pa kami. Ito yung klaseng coach na gusto niya gagaling talaga shumot kasi nga basketball is paramihan naman to. Actually paramihan ng score eh. Sinong mas maraming score yun yung mananalo, di ba? Hindi naman mananalo yung sinong pinakamaraming defensive stops eventually kung ano yung final score. Well, you coach personally as a coach, how do you recruit players? No, or meron ba mga specifics na hinahanap nyo? Kasi may ideal kayo. Sabi nyo, gusto nyo na may limang Scottie Pippen kayo sa loob ng court. Which is, to be honest, sobrang mahirap. No? Pero as a coach, paano nyo hinahanap yung mga ganyang klaseng players?
Well, is number one, it starts with kung meron bang magaling talaga, why not, di ba? But yung experience ko kasi with the FEU Juniors team, at that time, hindi siya hotspot in terms of recruitment. And especially TIP. Mm-hmm. So, alam namin na going into this, na we will not have the great players or the talented players needed to win. Or, basta, we will not have the talented players, period, or the skilled players, no? So, if we can't get the talented players or we can't get the skilled players, then we will get potential.
Okay.
So, that's number one. But, ano ba ang potential? How can you describe what potential is?
Yan, diba? Importante yan.
I think for me, everyone's a potential. Yeah? For me, everyone's a potential. If you're not good, then everyone has the potential. But, syempre, basketball to. Now, kung hindi ka na rin magaling at kung potential ka na lang din naman, edi kumuha ka na ng matatangkad. So, that's where the Scottie Pippen comes in. Ano? Because first of all, alam ko na pag may matatangkad na akong makukuha ang player, I'm sure they will not be skilled enough to play the kind of basketball na gusto ko, no? Wherein again, more of free flowing, more of five out, hindi siya limited to positions but rather positionless, no? So, we're willing naman, eh, no? We have that we have that program, we have the plans to develop players to play the way I want, ano? Because first and foremost, I think basketball is an art form. It's not science. It's not exact science. It's an art form. Therefore, there is a lot of ways going about basketball. There's a lot of ways to win a basketball game, and there are a lot of ways to play the game. And I choose a certain way of playing this game, and medyo stubborn ako when it comes to that because. Again, it's art. No? This is how I want basketball to be played. And with that, I just try my best and really my darn best to develop the kind of players that can play the way I want basketball to be played.
Yes.
So, yun yung akin. Ganun naman yung aking approach sa recruitment. Yung isang kaibigan ko ang coach, si Coach Rennie Rodejo na nasa Balayan, Batangas, ano, yung sa kainan sa kubo niya, he always reminds me, Coach, parang you are known to develop tall players.
Yes, oo, na-notice namin
and everything, yan. Ano? But, paano naman yung mga gwardiya, yung mga maliliit, wala bang lugar sa'yo? Napaisip din ako doon, ano? Actually, it was asked to me yata early last year, no? But, I was really contemplating on that question, parang, binabaliwala ko ba yung mga maliliit? May bias ba ako sa matatangkad? Kasi basketball pa rin. Kahit matatangkad ang players mo, I think basketball, ang heart and soul ng basketball, nasa mga gwardiya pa rin. Ano?
Mm-hmm.
And that is very true until now. No, international basketball, may mga matatangkad. Pero guess what? Sino ang mga team leaders nila? Mga point guards, karamihan. Sa France, si Campaso na napakagaling. Diba? Sa atin, sa Pilipinas, Jimmy Alapag, Ellen Tenorio. Yes. Though we have the Greg Slaughters, we have the Japet Aguilars, I think hindi makakatawid ng bola without the Jimmy Alapags, diba? And the Scotty Thompsons, and the Mark Barocas.
Correct.
So I think, looking back, I just looked at the point guards na dumaan sa programa namin, and they all went to college, no, yung mga high school point guards namin, RJ Argamino, who is playing sa MPBL.
Yes.
si Moy Eding, who played sa college, sa Lyceum, sa NCAA. Jens Newtel even went on to play for Barangay Hinebra, yes, sa PBA. These are point guards. Hindi ito matatangkad na sinasabi nilang naka-attach sa akin. Ano? But most of my point guards, even my point guards right now sa TIP, no? Unfortunately nga, nabitin kami. But our starting point guard, GC Karuruka na nasa Batangas, and Ato Daguro na nasa Manila, they've been asked to play sa MPBL now that they know na wala nang TIP program, wala nang hadlang ang pag-aaral so far ngayon, and they've been called up, no, sa MPBL. So even the guards naman sa amin, they're doing very well, ano. I think it's just really kasi pag guardia ka rito sa Pilipinas, automatic 'yun eh. Pag nagpa-tryouts ako sa TIP, 300 kids came to the TIP tryouts.
Wow.
Last summer, 300 kids spread out to 2 days, Saturday and Friday and Saturday. Sa 300 kids na 'yon, I think 280 point guards siya.
Para sa inyo, on your standard or point guards talaga sila?
No, I mean they cannot play the 6'4 power forward, okay, and up, di ba?
Yes, yes.
And you expect that to, I mean, every team at every level, at every league, pag nagpa-tryouts, more than 60%, sigurado ang magpapakita, guardia. And nakakatuwa nga dahil si Bert Flores, Coach Bert Flores ng FEU, nakakatawa yun eh, because every time we call a tryouts, puro guardia nga. Sabi ko, teka, hindi naman security agency ang pinapatak, ang pinapatryouts natin, but puro guardia dumarating. Sabi ni Bert, no? So I always use that line kasi totoo, no? Ang daming nangangarap na Pilipino maging player, but they do not have, una-una, they do not have the height to stand out. Ang my take is, kung maliit ka, better make sure sobrang galing mo.
Okay.
Kasi kung maliit ka, tapos you're just as good as everyone else, hindi ka magsa-stand out. And if you don't stand out, bakit ka kukunin?
Yun. Tama, diba? No? So, ibig sabihin, so, coach, no, especially pag dito ka sa province, and then specifically kasi yung mostly ng mga viewers natin ngayon is taga rito sa Zamboanga and sa province. If you really want to make it sa Manila and you're not that tall, sabi nga ni coach, mostly especially pag magta-tryout kayo, kung hindi kayo ma-recruit, kakompetensya nyo dyan, mga 80% puro point guards lang. So make sure habang nandito pa kayo sa Zamboanga or sa province, you master your craft kung maliit kayo as a point guard muna. Ha, di ba? And of course, kung gusto nyo pumunta kay coach, dapat magaling na kayong mag-shoot. At lalo pa kayong gagaling, ha, di ba?
I mean, a case in point, the last Zamboanga player who I worked with, and supposedly, no, nasa TIP na siya, but some unforeseen circumstances led him not to pursue or led me na putulin na yung relationship with him for TIP, no?
Okay.
He was Reagan Santos.
Oh, yeah.
He was, oh, not from Adamson Juniors, no? Reagan Santos was supposed to be one of the TIP players ko until now, no? But case in point, hindi siya ganun katangkaran, but he was so skilled and he was so smart and he was so fearless. Hindi mo siya pwedeng hindi kunin.
Okay.
Pero maliit siya, hindi siya makatangkaran, di ba? Mm-hmm. So that's what I meant when I say na kung maliit ka, you're a guard na 6 feet pababa ngayon, you better stand out. And I think there are three or two or some ways, no, para mag-stand out ang isang maliit na player. Number one, you have to be super fast. You have to be super quick. You have to be super explosive. That's number one. Number two, be the best shooter you can be. Maliit ka na nga, tas di ka pa makatira sa loob, sa labas, no? Ano gagawin mo? Poposte ka.
Correct.
Maybe logical lang.
Yeah, yeah.
Number three would be, alam mo, ang guardia, sinasabi nila kailangan guardia magaling pumasa. Dapat lang. Diba? So it's already normal. It's not something that should stand out. Kung guardia ka, kailangan marunong kang pumasa. So that is actually not part of my criteria anymore, no, for guards. Dapat marunong kang pumasa. Eh, dapat lang, 'di ba? Hindi ko na dapat pasalamatan ng guardia na marunong pumasa. But he has to shoot the lights out. He has to be athletic enough, to be fast enough, to be explosive enough. I think those two things, unang-una, those two things. And then number three, I think it's an X factor, it's an intangible, ano? Someone that could that can be successful despite failure. So I think to put it more eloquently, emotional quotient. So dapat mataas ang EQ ng mga players, especially the guards, kasi the guards will see more struggles sa basketball careers nila than the bigger, the taller players.
Okay, so pero minsan naman, coach, ito talking from coach to coach naman, no, ito parang humihingi na ako ng advice, no. Anyways, may mga time na may nagta-tryout sa atin or ni-refer sa atin na, yes, magaling, ah, may height. Pero minsan may nakikitaan nating attitude, eh. Diba? Minsan nakikita nyo, itong batang to, may problema to. Ah, medyo mayabang ba or matigas yung ulo. Do you still consider that, coach, na eto, coming in, magaling, yes, pero known siya na may reputation na maybe siguro lumalaban sa coach or you know, hindi siya good in attitude. Do you still recruit that kind of players? Or is there a way how you deal with them?
Yeah, surprisingly, I do give them chances, ano, lalo na kung magaling. Ng case in point, karamihan naman ng magagaling, part of their psyche may konting may konting attitude, di ba?
Yes, yes.
I mean,
may konting angas kung minsan.
I think kasi because for you to be great, you have to have that chip on your shoulder, ano, meron kang konting attitude na angas. But paminsan kasi misplaced lang yon, kaya nagkakaroon ng problema yung attitude niya. But yeah, surprisingly for me, even though I for what I stand for, I continue to patiently work with players na may attitude problem pero kasi may talent. Ano? Masaklap na nga, wala ka nang talent, may attitude problem ka pa. Eh, talagang out the door na yon.
Correct.
Diba? But if your talent makes you special, pero may problem ka attitude wise, then I will work with you. We work with them, ano? And we give them time to see the light and give them that time to change, no? But in my experience coaching, marami kaming pinagbigyan to work with, but meron mga umalis pa rin, ano? Or hindi kinaya na magbago or willing magbago for the better, and we had to cut him off pa rin. But there were players na masasamang bad eggs to start, but they were willing
eventually
to work it out, to become better, to become a good citizen, so to speak. And they've enjoyed a long career. No? And yeah, kasama yun, eh. Kasama yun sa buhay. Para walang pinagkaiba yan, Joseph, sa anak. Sa
correct
sarili nating mga anak. May mga anak tayong mabait, may mga anak na makukulit, but we don't let go. No? We don't let go. And we really just try to work with them to get better at it.
Well, coach, may nabasa kong isang article about you. I'm not sure kung kayo yung nag-quote noon. May mga players kayo nung time na nare-recruit kayo. Sorry for the language, I mean the term, na medyo reject ba yung tawag dyan sa ibang school, or yung hindi nakapasa sa ibang school, nakat, pero kinuha nyo at naging successful. Di ba?
Yeah.
Paano nyo nagawa yung coach? Kasi di ba sa iba wala na eh. Nakat ka na eh.
Well, again, like I shared kanina, no, na I am known for my energy. I'm known actually also for my passion in teaching and developing. Yes, I do believe I'm a very good skills coach just because I want to become one. And I'm willing really to work with players, no, hanggang mahirapan. Actually, mas sumusuko ang player bago ako sumuko sa kanila. And that's have happened a lot of times. Maybe someday si Mark Baroka would share yung mga nights namin working out bago ako umuwi
sa Saturday, coach, guest practice natin si Mark Baroka. Timing.
Yeah, Mark Baroka, no. Even RR, even Jens, everybody, no. Everybody who knows me, who I've worked with, would attest to my passion of teaching skills. And again, pinag-aaralan din 'yan, eh. Pinag-aaralan din as a coach kung paano ituro. Unfortunately, some coaches can teach, some coaches cannot. But those who cannot can also are good at strategies naman. I mean, may skills, eh. Ako siguro, I don't consider myself as a great strategist, ano? But I consider myself a great trainer, no? Yes, it's actually a badge of honor. Hindi dapat ikahiya na tinapon yung mga players na kinuha namin or pinagbigyan namin or binigyan namin ng chance were rejects, no? Talagang mga team B na bangko,
yes,
mga team B na na pwede namang guardia pero ginawang sentro dahil team bilang naman. So, yeah, they're rejects or mga hindi naman nabigyan talaga ng importansya or ng chance talaga ng mga former teams nila. And again, kung kukuha na lang din ako ng project to develop, then I'll get the tallest, longest possible players. Kasi at the end, ganun din. If I get a small player that I have to develop, it takes the same time and effort to develop a taller player. And if the taller player, at kung pipili ka ng player na maliit, na level 2, matangkad na level 2, sino kaagad ang kukunin mo?
Napakagandang point, coach. Diba? Very good
so
point.
It's the same. It takes the same amount of effort, time, know-how, sacrifice to develop whoever. Okay, kung mag-aaksaya na rin ako ng effort, edi I'll spend it on someone na matangkad kasi pag gumaling siya, it, again, my heart also for, I don't know, but my heart for Philippine basketball na sana mag-improve. I think it has to improve sa mindset ng mga coaches natin na matangkad, guardia pa rin yan. And it starts with the grassroots, it starts with the high school, it starts with the college players. Na porque you have to have the balls, no? I'm known to tell my players na hindi ako takot matalo basta masunod yung gusto ko.
Yun.
And yung masunod na gusto ko is really just the way basketball should be played. I dream of 5-6-5 players playing at the same time on the floor, playing positionless basketball, 5-6-5 players or above na shooter, no? So yun yung gusto ko at yun yung gusto kong i-impart sa basketball dito sa Philippines at yun yung gusto kong i-share, no? Siguro yun yung talk ako, so to speak. And honestly nga, if you throw in all the 6-5s and above sa akin, I guarantee gagaling yun. I wow. Guarantee makakapag level up yun sa international play, no? That's how confident I am in my skills development program.
Yun.
And it shows naman, ano? And
very well said, coach, no? Napakaganda yung sinabi nyo. I mean, it's a unique point, no? Hindi naman lahat pare-pareho yung coaches. Sa mga viewers, no? Eto, hindi to, Coach Putit is not talking in general. This is his own philosophy as a coach. Iba-iba naman yung mga coaches. Well, coach, hindi ko napansin. Sobrang sarap na kwento natin. Medyo nandito na tayo sa end part ng ano. Napakaganda, coach. Ako, personally, ang dami kong natutunan. Well, sa mga viewers, if you have any questions, throw it away, ha? Itatanong natin yan kay coach. Pero ako, coach, nawas, ano, eto medyo intrigue ako dito eh. Ano ba yung TIP way? Ang dami kong nakitang article na sinasabi or nagko-comment, go the TIP way, go TIP way. Ano ba yung TIP way?
It was really, we had to come up with a battle cry para malagay lang sa tamang path yung mga players namin. Tamang path in terms of work ethic, tamang path in terms of what they should be thinking, yung kanilang attitude towards a lot of things, towards life, no, towards manhood. So we came up with a phrase, no, the TIP way. It was a bit of a stretch for me dahil personally hindi ako komportable ng self-promotion, hindi ako komportable sa promotions. Ngayon lang ako natututo, no, because I think it's a necessity for me right now to come out more, to be coming out more comfortable talking about myself, ano. So yung TIP way really is just doing your best in doing the right things for the Lord. That's it. Wow. Now, that's the TIP way. And whenever we talk about the TIP way with the players, automatic, nagre-register sa kanila, number one, yung kanilang effort is very important. Not the results, but the effort. And number two, where that effort should be targeting, ano? What that effort should be focused on, and then who it is for the Lord. So, yun lang naman, ano? So, the TIP way is really doing the best that one can possibly do in doing the right things for the Lord. That's it. That's the TIP way.
Wow, napakaganda. Bottom line is, we are doing or you are doing everything for the Lord, no? What a noble way to ano. Now, coach, para sa inyo, coach, no, what do you think is your biggest accomplishment? Or, mabaga, pinaka-unforgettable moment sa coaching career nyo?
Well, recently, I think, one that really put tears in my eyes, ano, now that I'm sharing, nagiging emotional ako, no, I think one of the proudest moments ko recently was Jorey Napoles, a former TIP engineer,
yes,
got selected in the first round of the PBA draft. It doesn't need any explanation. TIP, basketball player, first round pick sa PBA. I mean, what more can you ask for, no, sa nagawa namin sa TIP? Small school, modest budget, lahat ng rason para hindi maging PBA player ang player ng TIP, no, nandoon na. But Jorey still beat the odds and became a PBA player and one of the more talked about PBA players now because of his potential, no. But 2012, pinagtatawanan si Jorey sa TIP ng mga kakampi niya dahil beginner talaga siya, nadadapa-dapa pa. Ang baon lang niya kaya ako siya kinuha was he was 6'3 and a half, 6'4.
Height pa rin.
And he was an active body, pero he was not skilled. He did not know how to play the game very well. Uncoordinated pa siya. And to see him in the PBA from 2012, now it's 2020, nasa PBA na siya. So that's one great accomplishment, or very proud moment for me. And maybe the second proudest moment ko, and I think this is because TIP got into the PBA D-League.
I remember that.
Last conference, we got, as a school-based team, TIP, walang reinforcements, no big budget. The TIP engineers got into the Final Four sa PBA D-League last conference. That was one of the prouder moments ko as a coach. No, trying to bring a team, a school like TIP to a place where mas na-recognize sila, no, for what they were even way back. No, they were already a good school before I came in. Mm-hmm. No, magandang eskwelahan na ang TIP ever since, ano. But again, sa atin sa Pilipinas, pag wala sa TV at hindi sikat sa basketball, parang anong eskwelahan yan?
Normally, NCAA, UAP lang talaga. Yung baga, eto lang pinagpipilian pag sa PBA.
Ayan ang pinanggagalingan ko lang. I know a lot of people now are shouting, ano, as they're watching, nako putit, wag mong puntahan yan. But yeah, no, I mean, UAAP, 8 eskwelahan, NC, 10. So that's just 18 schools. I cannot accept na the Philippines is just about 18 colleges. Di ba? But unfortunately, yan ang mindset ng karamihan eh. And going into TIP noong 2012, that was one of the, yun yung mga dalakong ano eh, mga dalakong plano for the TIP program. We were supposed to really be giant killers. On day one na pinakilala sa akin ng mga TIP players ni Sir Jello, I told the TIP players na we will be giant killers.
Wow.
Isa-isa nating patutumbahin yung mga UAP and NCAA teams na yan. And
very bold statement.
That was really one of the battle cries na in-establish ko since day one sa TIP.
Wow, very. Now coach, no, siguro hindi na kami mag-wonder, baka through this program baka may nanonood, eventually marirecruit kayo sa, you know, isang malaking school naman, ha. But coach, ito yung question ko ngayon. What if, syempre wala kayong team ngayon, isa sa nanonood dito ngayon yung GM ng Zamboanga MPBL team. What if kung na-recruit kayo, coach, ha, to coach for the Zamboanga team, tatanggapin niyo ba, coach? Ha? What if lang naman. What do you think, coach?
Sino nagtanong yan? Ikaw lang ba nagtanong yan?
Okay. Ako to, coach, kasi nakita ko kasi nanonood ngayon yung ano, GM ng Zamboanga team, which happens to be my friend. What if lang, although my coach sila ngayon, but you know, you can never tell the future, especially ang dami nyo ng fans dito sa Zamboanga and followers. So what if, coach, if that opportunity, you know, comes?
You know what? I've been sharing this to everyone, to my players, sa TIP, and until now, nawala na ako sa TIP, I still continue to live out this belief, ano. And ito yon, ano, I'll just share this, maybe my parting words to everyone, that you are where God puts you, and where God puts you, better make sure you do a good job. So I mean, yeah, thinking of the future is okay, planning for the future is okay, no, but it's also important to appreciate that where you are is where God puts you. And if God thinks that you have to be here right now, where you are right now, no, sa harap ng phones nyo or ng laptops or ng TVs nyo, that is where you're meant to be right now. No? May plano si God for you, and better make sure you do a good job where you are right now. So, yun lang. I'll just end it with that. No? Doon sa tanong mong yun. Mahirap sagutin yan because Coach Britt Reroma, alam mo naman ng Pilipino, masensitive sa mga ganyan eh, di ba? I mean, even si Tab Balvin, binato mo sa akin yung tanong na yun. I mean, as a people, very sensitive tayo, talupikon tayo eh. Kahit correct. Hindi na, napaka-objective dun sagot eh, pinipersonal kahit hindi naman. Ano? But yeah, I'm here. I am where God wants me to be, and I have to make sure I do a good job where I am right now.
Yun. Thank you very much, Coach. No? We are looking forward, Coach, for future collaborations maybe together with any Sambuanga basketball program.
Yeah,
now, Coach, any last word, Coach, para sa mga viewers natin? And of course, kung may mga gusto kayong i-shoutout and batiin. Go ahead, Coach.
Ako, shoutout, ang dami. Ang dami nag-request.
Go ahead, no? Coach.
Abutin tayo ng isang oras. But yeah, no. First of all, yung family ko, friends, family ko, For Eye Magic, yung mga De Vera, De Belen clan, and then yung Athletes in Action family ko. And then all my players, no? All the players I've worked with since I started coaching, and to the coaches I've worked with, you know, this has not been possible even without, it was also without them. So thank you so much for you, for everyone, and for everyone who's listening and watching. No, God is good, and chill lang kayo, relax lang kayo, no? Huwag kayong mataranta, don't panic, don't rebel. No, the great thing about where we are right now is, of course, this will end soon or maybe not soon, but it will end. The question is, when it ends, what kind of person will we become, and nasaan na tayo sa point ng buhay natin when everything ends and tuloy na ulit ang normal lives natin? Saan na tayo pupulutin? So that's something to think about.
Yun. Thank you very much, Coach. No, kami dito sa Big Fundamental Basketball Academy, we are very much honored to have a very unique, one of the best coach sa Philippines basketball, perhaps in the world. No, a really bright mind. Ah, none other than Coach Potit. Coach, ang daming nagpapa-shoutout dito. Sorry kung hindi namin ma-shoutout lahat. Ha? Medyo gaul na kami sa oras. Siguro, Coach, ha? In the near future, part 2 naman tayo, Coach. Ang dami ko pang gustong tanungin sa'yo, Coach. And, you know, like, pick your brain a little bit. No, but then again, limited yung time natin. Actually, ang dami nating napagkwentuhan. Ha? Shoutout lang kay Noy Tuble, ha? Isa sa mga great basketball players sa Sambuanga. Kay Coach Khan Basiri, ha? Anak ni Sir Omar. Shout out din kay Coach Anthony Lu. Napakadaming coach, local coach sa Sambuanga na nanonood. I'm sure they've learned a lot. RJ Argamino, ha? Nag-raise ng hand. He is watching right now. Well, Coach, thank you very much for the opportunity na pinaunlakan nyo sa amin. I know how busy you are, and especially yung time ngayon dyan sa Manila, no? But we are really honored to have you here, Coach. You are the second coach or the second na hindi Sambuanggenyo na nag-guest dito. But, you know, We will treat you now as our own. We are looking forward to your next team, Coach. We will cheer for you. And of course, nami-miss na namin yung voice nyo after the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ayan, palakpakan muna natin si Coach.
Thank you. It's a pleasure. I had fun. And I can keep on going kung gusto nyo, but I am having fun right now. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Okay, so there you have it, ha, mga viewers. Magtsatsabakano na ako, Coach, ha? Talio Ceres sa pwede mira, ha? Kung Coach Potit De Vera, ha? De Vera katle, De Verasa na parte de la Sambuanga Basketball. Kaya pakat kami sa Largo, pero sabi naman ustedes, limited datun oras. Actually, lampas sa kita na ora, no? So this has been another presentation of the Big Fundamental Basketball Academy, live here at Gold Live Sambuanga, and also broadcasted via the eMedia platform. My name is Coach Joseph Romarate. Together with me is Coach Potit De Vera saying, see ya, ballers. Bye-bye. Thank you, Coach.
Gold Live Sports and Entertainment.